Hey everybody, happy Monday.
Happy Monday everyone. We've got a very interesting video for you today, and it was based on some of the observations you made. And in this video, I think we need to maybe call out some of those in the aquarium industry, because there's something they're doing that is actually ruining things for aquarium hobbyists. And we're going to address one of those things today. What is that thing?
The packaging, the picture on the tank.
So when you look at, and some of you, I think we just get used to this, but when you look at the types of fish that are shown on the packaging of some of the tanks that are being sold in the industry, you quite simply, the package itself is giving horrible advice. And we wanted to bring you a few examples today, and hopefully the industry can change the way that they are representing the fish tanks that they sell and the fish on this packaging. Now, I get it. People should be doing their research. They should be understanding what fish go in what size tanks. There's lots of information out there, but unfortunately, perception is reality. When you've got these pictures on these tanks, that basically tells people, here's the fish you can put in this tank that you're about to buy. Not only that, but when you do this, you put employees in a bad situation when they buy a 5-gallon tank. Like, well, I want to put these fish in the 5-gallon. Why can't I do it? They're right here on the picture. And now a store employee has to tell you, well, I know that's what's on the picture, but that's not really what you can put in this size tank. Or they don't even know enough to challenge that. And then you wind up with somebody who puts some fish in a tank where they just don't belong. Here are some really good examples. Example number one.
Okay, I'm going to read the ones that I took pictures of and that really caught my eye in the store.
And we'll put the picture up on the screen.
Yeah, and then you can elaborate.
All right, okay. So number one.
Now this first one has an extra detail that I think is very interesting. Okay, number one is the Aquarium Bedabo 1. That's a 1-gallon. It's also sold as a mini bow one. It's the same tank, just marketed differently. So one, of course, the betta bow has a picture of a betta in it and a 1-gallon tank. And the funniest thing about this is that the proportions of the fish are changed for the picture. So the fish looks small and the tank looks really big, where it's not really to scale. But the mini bow one is even more fun because it pictures two leading heart tetras in it.
So obviously we've got some problems with this. By the way, we've done stocking options on just about every size tank that you can imagine. We went as low as a 2.5. And if you watch that video, you will notice that we put almost, it was a very short video because there's not a whole lot you can even put in a 2.5. Something less than a 2.5-gallon really isn't appropriate for fish, period. Mm-hmm. There's really nothing more to say about that. And so bettas, I'm sorry, they really should be. And I know some of you, even with the 2.5-gallon, you're like, whoa, that's really a pretty small tank. I get that. And we've talked about that before in terms of if you've got an active betta, they need a bigger tank. If you've got one that's not very active, maybe a 2.5 is okay. But a 1-gallon tank should not be housing fish. And then you've got the bleeding heart tetras in this. Was it 1.6 gallon?
1 gallon.
Oh, and a 1-gallon. Bleeding heart tetras, first of all, they're a medium-sized tetra. They're not even a small tetra. It should be kept in large groups of at least 8 to 10 in a tank that gives them plenty of swimming space. In my opinion, that's a fish that you'd probably really reserve for a 20-gallon or greater. And here they are, two of them in this tank. Again, the point here is these tanks are representing fish that should not be kept in this size, in this volume. All right, what else you got?
All right, number two, the Aquarium Mini Cube 1.6. And before we go any further, I really appreciate Aquarium's their slogan. It's all about the fish.
All right, so if it's all about the fish, what do we got here?
In this 1.6 cube tank, you have pictured a dwarf gourami, but there is a badge in the corner of the package that says, also great for small tropical fish, and it pictures a guppy.
And again, a 1.6-gallon tank is not sufficient for really any fish, especially a dwarf gourami. By the way, that's not even the smallest type of gourami. No. You could go sparkling gourami or even honey gourami. A dwarf gourami is a fairly active, relatively, I would say, medium-sized gourami that's going to be about 2.5 to 3 inches. And again, it's just my personal opinion. You're probably with a dwarf gourami best in a 20-gallon or larger. Could you do a 10-gallon? Maybe. But this is not a tank that is capable of holding fish for the duration of their life long term. By the way, would love to hear from you down in the comments section below. Which one of these examples do you think is the worst example of fish keeping?
Yeah, which one really irks you the most?
All right, what's the next one?
This one makes me mad, both the tank size and the fish, because this is both of these are very common ones that are drawn that a beginner fish keeper would be drawn to. Okay, so it's the Aquion. Remember, it's all about the fish.
It is.
The basic 10, it's the kit. It has it all. So it's a great beginner tank.
It is a great
whoa, it has it all. But they also put in a very common fish, I think, that people are drawn to when they're first coming into the hobby, goldfish, and it pictures three goldfish.
So three goldfish in a 10-gallon. One of the first videos we did was whether or not goldfish are right for you. I'm going to put that in the upper right-hand corner as well as in the description below. And yes, goldfish are really cool. The problem is, if you were to watch that video, these were common comet goldfish. In fact, they started out as feeder fish, which would have been only like an inch or two. And these magnificent, beautiful fish grew to 6 inches plus. And when you include the fins, maybe 7 inches, each one of them. Common rule of thumb is if you're going to keep a single one, you're probably looking at least a 40-gallon breeder. And I had four or five of them in that tank. And I remember people saying, are you eventually going to move them to a larger tank? And the answer was, yes, I rescued those fish. And now we need to figure out plan B, which was going to be for three goldfish. Would a 40-gallon breeder make it? It would be really tough to justify putting them in there. But those fish eventually found their way into a pond of one of my friends where they have still lived a long and happy life. If I were keeping them, moving them out of the 40, they would have gone into a 125. Not ever a 10-gallon tank. So putting goldfish in anything less than at least a 3-foot tank, even one of them, you're really pushing it. And then the general rule of thumb is after you, for each goldfish you add, you want another 20 gallons of water. So three of them in a 10 gallon is a really bad idea. Now, it's a great idea if you want to stunt the growth of the fish, if you want to have massive problems with water quality, and you want to make sure your fish live a miserable life long term. But again, we need to set a better example. What's the next one?
All right. This one is the Imagitarian 5.2 cube. And it pictures five neons and one really very pretty pleco.
In a what size?
5.2 cube.
So 5.2 gallon cube. By the way, we've done a review on the Imagitarian. I think it was like a 3.7. It was a pretty decent tank. So it's not about the equipment here. It's about the way these fish are being represented in the hobby by people who should know better. So we've got this little 5.2 gallon. Mm-hmm. We've got five neons. Mm-hmm. All right, so that's, I mean, okay, it's not the most horrible thing in the world. Personally, I don't like to keep neons in a tank that small. I would prefer a 10-gallon, and I would prefer a larger group, maybe 8 to 10. But it's like, all right, it's not, certainly out of this, it's probably not the worst example. I think the thing that really sticks out is you said there's a pleco, a bristlenose pleco in there. We'll assume it's a super red bristlenose pleco. And these are fish where the males can grow up to 6 inches. I've got male bristlenose plecos that are at least 6 inches, the females 4 to 5 inches. They're not very active, but they need more space. Not only that, these are fish that love to eat. They have a big appetite. In a little tank like that, if you're feeding these fish the way they were meant to be fed, you're going to have massive water quality issues in a very short period of time. And what is that going to do for someone who's new to the hobby? If they're constantly battling water parameter issues, that's going to be a quick exit. It's not worth the hassle. These plecos, we have some of them, smaller ones, in some of our 10 gallons that we cycle out into larger tanks, but really a 20 gallon tank is ideal for a bristlenose pleco. And yeah, so it comes down to making sure the fish on these packages are actually fish that can go in the tanks that are being sold. Next.
All right, this is the last example.
Last example.
Are you ready? This is one of the tanks we really love. It's the Fluval Spec 5. And it features a very high-end looking scape, real plants, nice driftwood. And this is pictured with 12 neons, two guppies, and two mystery snails.
In a 5-gallon.
Okay. In a 5-gallon.
So again, the Fluval Spec 5 is a fantastic tank. We've got one here, like it a lot. The issue is not the tank. The issue is what are we showing people that can go into this tank. So we've got a dozen neons, you said. Again, that's a 5-gallon with a dozen neons is on the small side. Mm-hmm. You really need at least double that volume. First of all, neons are a relatively... That was water flowing.
fish room.
Yeah, we're doing fish room maintenance today. But first of all, the neons are a relatively active fish. And when you're giving them 5 gallons of space, that's not enough. You need at least 10 gallons, if not slightly more, for the neons. You said a couple guppies?
Yeah.
If you just had the couple guppies in there, that's fine. But I think when you're trying to pack them in there with neons, that could be bad. And what else was in that tank? Or is that it?
A couple mystery snails. A
couple mystery snails, perfectly acceptable. But again, we're not necessarily reflecting what can accurately go in a tank this size. Mm-hmm. If you want more information, like I said, on stocking options, check out the videos in the description below for these smaller tanks. But hopefully we've learned a couple things. One, anything less than a 2.5, and you're really pushing the lower boundary. In fact, probably not a good idea. Not only that, with these smaller tanks, you're going to have to deal with water parameter issues as it is. And when you put fish in a tank that doesn't belong, it makes it even worse.
So if you like this video, then you may want to stop by the Small Scape on Wednesday and check out my video, because it kind of includes some of this fun stuff there too.
And again, we'd love to hear from you in the comments section below. Which one do you think was the craziest of them all? This is not meant to rip any one aquarium manufacturer, but it is meant to be a little bit of a wake-up call. Just got to do better. You got to do better in the aquarium industry if you want people to stay in the aquarium hobby. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you want more information and how to care for some of the fish mentioned, check out this video down here in the lower part of the screen. We'll have the species profiles down in the description. We'll see you in the next one.
Bye.